Did you know that scientists are working on a mega project that is supposed to be the most expensive science experiment ever? This project is so massive that it brought together 35 countries to build it. And once it is complete, it could solve our global climate crisis. This sounds too good to be true, but it is real. So, what project am I talking about? What exactly are these brilliant minds building? Before we have a look, please subscribe. Currently, we are facing a serious energy crisis. Our world runs on energy, and as technology advances, our demand for energy just keeps increasing. Think about it. Every new gadget, every electric car, and now all these advanced AI models require tons of energy to operate. This demand has put a huge strain on our current energy sources. For example, the International Energy Agency has predicted that global energy demand will increase by about 4% by the end of this year. That's a massive jump. The situation has been made worse with the introduction of new AI models because every new model needs as much energy for training as about 100 US homes consume in a whole year. This is why we need a solution, something that could meet our energy needs. Other than that, we have seen some serious global implications of our current energy methods. Fossil fuels, which still provide a large portion of our energy, are causing major environmental damage. Air pollution, oil spills, greenhouse gas emissions, and whatnot. All these are leading to climate change. Renewable sources like wind and solar are fantastic, but they have limitations. So, what's the solution? Well, this is where things get exciting. The European Union, along with Russia, China, India, and the US, came together to find a better way. They decided to aim high and look at the best source of thermal energy we know, the sun. The sun, like all stars, generates energy through a process called nuclear fusion. This is a phenomenon where two atomic nuclei combine to form a heavier nucleus and release a massive amount of energy in the process. This is the same process that powers our sun and all the stars in the universe. The idea was to replicate this process here on Earth. So they decided to build a massive nuclear fusion reactor. They named it the International Thermonuclear Experimental Reactor, or ITER for short. This nuclear fusion reactor will use nuclear fusion to create a tremendous amount of energy. It is the opposite of nuclear fission, which is splitting atoms apart and is what our current nuclear power plants use. Fusion is cleaner, safer, and could potentially provide limitless energy. But why are we just thinking about this? Why didn't we build this reactor sooner? Well, creating the same conditions that are inside stars is no easy task. The most common design for fusion reactors is called a tokamak, and this design involves superheating plasma, which is one of the four states of matter. Plasma consists of positive ions and negatively charged free electrons. This plasma is then trapped inside a donut-shaped reactor chamber using powerful magnetic fields. The tricky part has been keeping the superheated plasma stable long enough for nuclear fusion to happen. Scientists were struggling to find a way to do this for a reactor. Back in 1958, Soviet scientist Natan Yavnalinsky designed the first tokamak. But since then, no one has managed to create a reactor that produces more energy than it takes in. One of the biggest challenges is handling plasma that is hot enough to fuse. Fusion reactors need extremely high temperatures, much hotter than the sun because they operate at much lower pressures than the cores of stars. For example, the sun's core reaches about 15 million degrees Celsius and has pressures 340 billion times the air pressure at sea level on Earth. Heating the plasma to these temperatures is the easy part. The tough part is containing it, so it does not burn through the reactor or disrupt the fusion process. This containment is usually done using either lasers or magnetic fields. Scientists have been refining their techniques to solve this problem. More than 100 fusion reactors have been built since the 1950s, but they have all faced significant obstacles. Now, ITER aims to overcome these hurdles as the largest fusion reactor ever built. The project is being built in southern France, in a place called Saint-Paul-lès-Durance. It is an enormous undertaking, with a complex covering around 450 acres. The size and scale of ITER are mind-blowing. Once completed, it will be the largest tokamak ever built. Just imagine that this facility will weigh about 23,000 tons, which is equivalent to 3 Eiffel Towers. It will have a plasma volume of 840 cubic meters, making it 6 times larger than the JT60SA tokamak in Japan, which currently holds the record. What makes ITER truly amazing is its potential to produce massive amounts of energy from a very small amount of fuel. For example, just 1 gram of a deuterium-tritium fuel mixture used in nuclear fusion can create 90,000 kilowatt hours of energy. To put that in perspective, that's equivalent to burning 11 tons of coal. So, where do scientists get this fuel? Deuterium is readily available and can be extracted from seawater, making it nearly inexhaustible. Tritium, on the other hand, is much rarer. It occurs only in trace amounts in nature, and the world's current supply, primarily produced by heavy water CANDU fission reactors, is only about 20 kilograms per year. This is nowhere near enough for future fusion power plants. However, ITER has a plan to address this challenge. The reactor will be testing a tritium breeding blanket technology. This means tritium will be produced within the reactor itself, potentially making future fusion reactors self-sufficient in terms of fuel supply. One of the biggest advantages of this reactor is that it will produce virtually no CO2 emissions or atmospheric pollutants, which mean it won't contribute to climate change or air pollution. There's also no risk of a meltdown, which is usually a major concern for current nuclear fission reactors. Also, the radioactive waste produced by fusion is much less hazardous and shorter-lived compared to the waste from fission reactors. Overall, fusion energy represents a cleaner, safer, and more sustainable alternative to our current energy sources. And with ITER leading the way, we are getting closer to making this futuristic power source a reality. So, when will it eventually be completed? The journey of ITER began back in 1978, when the European Commission, Japan, the United States, and the USSR came together for the International Tokamak Reactor Workshop. Between 1978 and the mid-1980s, hundreds of fusion scientists and engineers from each participating country took part to assess the tokamak confinement system and explore design possibilities for generating nuclear fusion energy. In 1985, the countries decided to build the ITER together, and the project was initiated in 1988. Then in 2007, the ground was officially broken for ITER. The construction of the ITER tokamak complex began in 2013. By April 2022, ITER was about 85% complete toward achieving its first plasma. Originally, the first plasma run was scheduled for late 2025. However, as it is with every mega project, there were some delays. In 2020, construction was paused due to COVID restrictions. When it resumed, engineers discovered cracks in some already installed parts. Unfortunately, this revealed a deeper problem. Some of the components that had been produced by different companies didn't fit together properly. This misalignment caused stress where there shouldn't have been any, which led to helium leaks, corrosion, and eventually cracks. Due to these delays, the project completion has been pushed back to 2039. In July 2024, ITER announced a whole revised schedule. It says that the team will reach full plasma current by 2034. It will start operations with deuterium-tritium plasma in 2035 and begin deuterium-tritium operations in 2039. Now, let's talk about the price tag. It is huge. Scientists thought the Large Hadron Collider was expensive for them with its 7.5 billion euro budget because that project almost drained everyone's pockets. But ITER? This has crossed all budget limits. The initial budget was close to 6 billion euros, but the total cost of construction and operations is now estimated to be between 18 billion euros and 22 billion euros. Some estimates even suggest that the total cost will be between 41 billion euros and 60 billion euros. So yes, it is a pricey endeavour, but the potential payoff would be absolutely game-changing. Strangely, the overall goal of ITER was never to produce energy for the electricity grid. The primary goal of ITER is to provide valuable data for other fusion projects, and to attract private investments to commercialize fusion technology. But with the recent delays, private companies might take the lead, potentially making ITER unnecessary. However, there's also a chance that those startups could fail. Plus, private companies often keep their data secret, so a collaborative project like ITER might still be necessary. The ITER project has faced a lot of heat from critics. People are worried about its environmental impact and the project's goals. When France was picked as a site for ITER in 2005, some European environmentalists were not happy. For example, French politician Noël Mamer argued that investing 10 billion euros in a project with a 30 to 50 year timeline was not a smart idea for tackling global warming right now. Some scientists within the fusion community have also thrown shade at ITER. They argue that other fusion projects could be cheaper and more effective. Some believe that non-tokamak systems could achieve results at a fraction of ITER's costs. The tokamak design has its own set of issues. In 2013, new data showed that the power load on a tokamak's diverter could be 5 times higher than expected, which led to design changes and increased costs. Critics have raised valid concerns, but ITER is exactly what we need right now. Fission reactors have not been enough to meet our growing energy demands. This criticism is understandable, but it overlooks the potential of fusion as a green energy source. ITER is designed to be environmentally friendly, addressing those worries. Those in charge of this project are confident that in 100 years, we will look back and be grateful we started this project. According to them, building ITER is a bold step towards a sustainable future, promising cleaner, safer, and virtually limitless energy. What do you think about ITER? Share your opinions with us in the comments below. If you made it to the end, thanks for watching. Before you go, make sure to like and subscribe to make my day. See you in the next one.